I've been up for a long time. Oh my. Oh my. Oh my.
Hi, I'm Jordan Havisi. This is my 2010 SSV Redline. It's the first year that the Redline was ever produced for the Holden Commodore, and it's a Voodoo Blue Metallic. It's a 6-speed manual, 6-litre V8 L77. Always been a Commodore fan. Growing up, my dad, he was very much in the cars. He was a mechanic. I've always had Commodore since my first car. Pretty much every car after that has been a Commodore. This is my third V8 now. So I started off with a VS Berliner, and then went to, as soon as I got my full license, the first day I got my full license, I got a VE SSV. Then shortly after that, I got a VE Series 1 SS. And then when I saw this SSV Redline up for sale, I jumped on it. It was my first manual as well. I've always loved the body shape of it. It's a nice body shape, very aggressive looking. Also, when I first drove a VE, it was a very, very good car, like very well balanced. Compared to the older model Commodores, they were a bit boaty and some were a bit understeery as you push them into the corner. The VE was a different car to drive altogether. Since buying it, I've fitted some XYZ coilovers all around, polyurethane bushings throughout, a white line sway bar inlink, Bone Performance, which is an American company, rear trailing arms. They're chromoly steel tubular trailing arms that are they're lightweight and stronger than what's on the car normally. It's got a upgraded intake, ProFlow 4-inch intake pipe with high-flow air filter. The exhaust is a Hurricane 1 7/8 headers and a twin 3-inch system all the way back, and there's no mufflers on the car whatsoever. I haven't dynoed it. The car already had an intake and exhaust on it when I bought it, and then I had it retuned remotely through a company called Oztrak. They give you out like a little mobile PCM tuner. I'm gonna get it on the dyno when I get a cam done in the future, hoping for around 300, 320 rear wheel kilowatts, just your standard sort of kilowatt figure for these cars. So future mods that I have for the car, I'm gonna be doing a lightweight drive shaft, try and cut some of the weight. Weight's the enemy with these cars. A Harrop True Track diff, try and keep the car a bit more planted around the corners. I'm gonna be doing a cam, a bit more power for the car. I'm gonna be looking at some underbody bracing as well, probably a strut brace. So on the VE Series 2, they don't have the rear Brembo brakes, it's only on the front. Same deal with the VF Series 1. So I've purchased brakes from a Camaro in the US, used brakes, only about $150 Australian dollars, so quite a good deal. Then from there, I bought some different brake rotors and rotor bolts, and that's all you need to fit them up. It makes a world of difference. Some more things I want to do to the exterior of the car is just a bunch of aero work. So I'm looking at getting a new front splitter, side splitter, and custom rear diffuser. It's both more of a visual thing than an aerodynamic thing, but I'm sure there might be some aerodynamic aid in doing it. Probably looking at getting some touch-ups done on the car, like probably a respray on the front bumper, just some basic tidying up work. It's an exciting car to drive. Even not just all that performance, like handling as well, it's actually a really well-balanced car. I love chucking in corners, and I love being able to just floor it out of the corner, and it has that response that you want from a V8. Yeah, so these are just the RNS series plates, they're called. They're cheaper than your normal customized plate. Luckily, it was able to work with the SSV, the car obviously being an SSV Redline. And then the 364 is the cubic capacity of the engine. So 6 litres is 364 cubic inches. So the wheels are a Vettini Magic. They're a flowform wheel. I wanted something that was lightweight because the car, being an SSV Redline, came with forged factory wheels, but I wanted something that was a bit more aggressive in style and black. And I didn't want to lose out on handling, so I went for the Vettini Magics. And funny enough, they actually turned out to be lighter than the factory forged Holden wheels. And then I'm just running Nitto Invo tyres. Really good value for money. I take it regularly to meets. I run a Holden Commodore page on Facebook. It's Holden Commodore SS Fan Club. I have taken it to Malala once before, and there are plans to take it to the Bend. I want to take it to Malala and the Bend more often. That's the idea behind all the modifications for the car. Is I want to build a car that is more track focused, and it sounds like an unrealistic goal to many, but I want to be able to keep up with an R34, Nissan GTR, a stock one of course. Yeah, growing up, I've always loved V8 supercars. And what's good about the V8 supercars is it's more focused on handling rather than all that performance. The cars themselves aren't crazy high horsepower numbers, but they're really about the driver and about the handling of the car. Yeah, the VE model V8 supercars were definitely my favorite generation of supercar. They always had a nice livery on them and aggressive styling. Yeah, this color, it was only produced for 1 year in the VE Series 2, which this is. It was fairly common in the VE Series 1, Voodoo Blue the colour. In the SSV Redlines, this is also a rare colour as well. And for the SSV Redline in the VE Series 2, there weren't many produced. There were less than 600 produced in the VE Series 2, as this was the first year, not many people knew about them. There was approximately 180 manuals produced, and this is one of the 180 manuals. The Redline, it comes with forged alloy wheels. They're a 19x8 forged. It comes with the thicker sway bars, FE3 suspension, so that's the FE3 shocks and springs from the HSV R8. It comes with the Brembo front brake calipers. I think this is perfect for what I want because I like to modify my cars. I like to make it my own, and there's a lot of work to be done on it. I like to be hands-on with my cars. The coilovers, it just changed the whole dynamics of the car. It made the steering feel lighter, but it also makes the whole car feel more planted and connected to the road. Just basics, like I've done a bit of a blackout on the car, so I've blacked out the badges, and I've put some Corvette Grand Sport inspired racing stripes here on the fenders. Most of the lighting on the car has been converted to LEDs, just the small touches that make the car a little bit nicer. Yeah, I like a clean style, and I wanted to just make it a little bit more out there with the fender stripes, but still keep it clean. I think if I sold this car, I'd miss the rawness of it, because this is just before that generation of cars where everything was electronically enhanced, so it doesn't have like a track mode, it doesn't have a launch control. Like, yes, it has electronic stability control, like traction control, that sort of stuff. That's still fairly basic. And it's just a raw rear-wheel drive V8, and I feel connected to it.